In today's video, I am going to discuss about organic chemistry, first year organic chemistry introduction part and nomenclature, some functional groups names I am going to discuss. First year organic chemistry, we are going to learn 40%. 40% first year organic chemistry and second year organic chemistry 60%. But the 60% organic chemistry, it depends on first year topic. First year, if you have good command, definitely second year organic chemistry feels very easy. And nomenclature and some additional points in first year itself we are learning. Second year, just we mention the names. That's it. We are not discussing detailed explanation. So everybody, so listen along with me. You also take paper and pen, write the notes. Definitely, it's easy organic chemistry you feel. So now introduction part. So in organic chemistry, mainly we are learning backbone of organic chemistry. Backbone of organic chemistry. Backbone of organic chemistry, carbon. Carbon compounds only we are learning. Why we are learning carbon compounds only? Actually, first synthesized organic compound is urea. That is introduction part, one point. And afterwards, why we are learning carbon compounds? Why we are learning organic chemistry? Why in organic chemistry, main backbone is why carbon? So why carbon? First important one is tetravalency of carbon. Tetravalency of carbon. This is one of the reason to show many compounds carbon. Okay. So second one is tetravalency of carbon. I am going to discuss here itself. So many times we have learned about atomic numbers. Look into the students. Carbon. Carbon atomic number 6. Its electronic configuration 1s2 and 2s2. What about this guy? 2p2. If you will take excited state electronic configuration, directly I am writing students, ground state is nothing but 2s, here 2 electrons and 2p, p means 3 boxes, right? Here 2 electrons I have written. This is what ground state. Excited state, if you will take excited state, means this electron jumps here, paired electron jumps into vacant orbital, right? That's it, right here. This is excited state. In excited state, carbon has 4 unpaired electrons. Carbon has 4 unpaired electrons. Unpaired electrons only participate in bond formation. Because of 4 unpaired electrons, its valency equal to 4. Its valency equal to 4. This is the one of the reason to show many compounds. Many compounds that we call it as organic compounds. So main backbone is carbon. Okay, now second property. What is the second one? It plays important role again. Catenation property. Catenation. Catenation property is nothing but self-linkage. Catenation property is nothing but self-linkage. Self-linkage. So like this, carbon skeleton, carbon, 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 like this. This type of skeleton like it will form because carbon has ability to form self linkages. Carbon, 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 like this. Because of this property also we are learning more compounds, those organic chemistry compounds, right? Now next important point is students, in periodic table, highest catenation property, highest catenation property showing is carbon. Highest catenation carbon. Afterwards we are seeing some compound silicon and sulfur also, but highest catenation property have carbon. That's why many organic compounds we are learning. And the third important point is multiple bonds. Multiple bonds. carbon has ability to form multiple bonds, and you will get CC single bond. Okay, multiple bonds is nothing but C double bond C, C triple bond C, like this. Definite, this is single bond. Here we have learned self linkages. Multiple bonds is nothing but double bond, triple bond, like this, and two sides double bond also. Because of these three main reasons, we are learning many organic chemistry compounds. So finally, what is the conclusion, students? Here we are learning carbon compounds. Carbon compounds, I am writing here. So final conclusion point, I am writing carbon compounds, that is backbone in organic chemistry, carbon. Now next important one is hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons is nothing but carbon and hydrogen only. Only hydrogen, carbon, only carbon and hydrogen. So that we are learning in first year. Those are alkenes, alkynes, arenes. But in second year organic chemistry, we are learning some additional functional group, C double bond OH, like this, along with the carbon and oxygen. Along with the carbon and hydrogen, oxygen, along with the carbon and hydrogen, along with the nitrogen, like this compounds also we are learning. So this is the introduction part of organic chemistry. Clear, students? Now, to save the time, I have written here classification. We'll go through the classification. Classification of organic compounds. First, we have divided into mainly three types. Those are acyclic compounds. Another one is cyclic. Acyclic is nothing but not cyclic. Not cyclic. Okay, now acyclic compounds, also call it as aliphatic compounds. Aliphatic is nothing but the organic compounds are in the form of chain. Okay, I will show the chain also, or else we call it as open chain compounds. Open chain compounds. So let me complete left hand side first. Open chain compounds. Open chain compounds further classified into two types, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated is nothing but single bonds, that is alkenes. Unsaturated, sooty flame, non-sooty flame, actually laboratory test also there, but on paper saturated compounds is nothing but it has single bond. Unsaturated compounds is nothing but multiple bonds, that is double bond and triple bond. See, general molecular formulas also I have written. So CnH2n+2, if you substitute your n equal to 1, you will get methane, and n equal to 2, you will get ethane, like this. Okay, students. Now my double bonds. Double bonds, what is the molecular formula? See, single bond, what is the molecular formula? CnH2n+2. And in alkenes, CnH2n. This is CnH2n-2. This is ethene. This is xylene. This is ethene. This is what? Methane. And this is what? Ethane. Like this. Next important one is, this is acetylene. This is, what is the general molecular formula? CnH2n-2. N equal to 2, you'll get C2H2, acetylene. Acetylene also call it as, what is the IUPAC name? Ethyne. Okay, this one. Now, right hand side, cyclic compounds we have seen. Cyclic compounds, classified, cyclic compounds is nothing but closed chain, closed ring structures. This is classified as homocyclic, heterocyclic. Homocyclic, hetero. Homo is nothing but same. Same. That I will show with examples also. This is alicyclic. Homocyclic further classified into alicyclic, aromatic. Aromatic is nothing but like I will show Huckel's rule and all down I have written points. And next to this is heterocyclic. Heterocyclic compounds is nothing but here heterocyclic compounds further classified into aromatic and non-aromatic. So once again, cyclic compounds means closed ring structures. These are classified into homocyclic and heterocyclic. Homocyclic is further classified into alicyclic and aromatic compounds. Here also aromatic and non-aromatic. So alicyclic compounds, aromatic compounds. These aromatic compounds further divided into benzenoid compounds, non-benzenoid compounds. This is benzenoid compounds, non-benzenoid. Benzene ring. and which is not having benzene ring. We call it as non-benzamide. That's it. This is the introduction part, classification of organic compounds. I have written some definitions down to understand more better. Alicyclic compounds. Alicyclic compounds. This is one of the point we are using. Compounds are having same molecular formula. One second. Compounds are the cyclic. Compounds are the cyclic, which are closed properties to open chain structures. Compounds are the cyclic, which are closed properties to open chain structure. See students here, this is N-butane. N-butane. Butane means four carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four carbons, right? Write down. Four carbons. How many hydrogens? See students, sometimes they will give skeleton like this. This is nothing but N-butane only. Main backbone is carbon. Along with this, definitely hydrogen. If they are not given other atoms, means you have to write like, you have to write hydrogens. You have to fill with hydrogens. How to fill with hydrogens? The first important point is carbon valency. How much carbon valency? 4. That means around carbon, it has 4 bonds. See, here CC single bond. It means CH3. Here 3 bonds, here 1 bond, 4. This is also end CH3. And here CH2. And here CH2. Like this. That structure only I have written here. What is the molecular formula? C4, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 2, 7, 7 plus 3, 10. C4H10 molecular formula I have written N-butane. This is cyclic. What is this? What is this? Acyclic. Acyclic is nothing but not cyclic. Not cyclic. Okay, this is N-butane. This is cyclobutane. The same molecular formula. See, here also you can calculate C4. And how many hydrogens? 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. Same way you can calculate molecular formula here. C4H8. See. Two hydrogens is decreased. Two hydrogens is decreased because it is cyclic structure. Because it is cyclic structure. So finally, what I am trying to say, this is acyclic, this is alicyclic, okay, alicyclic. This is what we call it as cyclobutane. This is N-butane. Long chain is nothing but N-butane. This is what we call it as cyclobutane. Clear, students? Now, next important one is aromatic compounds. Aromatic compounds. Aromatic. Aromatic again, benzenoid compounds, non-benzenoid compounds. In coming upcoming videos, I am going to do more detailed explanation, aromatic, anti-aromatic, non-aromatic. But here, introduction time, I am going to give only few points, students, to you. Cyclic. It should be cyclic. Any compound which is aromatic means the first satisfaction rule is cyclic. And it should be planar and continuous conjugation. It obeys Huckel's rule. Huckel's rule. Huckel's rule is nothing but 4n plus 2 pi electrons, where n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So now see students, I am taking one example. This is benzene ring. Okay, benzene ring I have taken. First one, it is cyclic. It is in planar shape. All are in one plane. So continuous conjugation. So this is continuous conjugation, right? So write down its structure. You may write like this also, no? Yes, this is. You can write like this. Alternate to double bonds, you can write like this also. 4N plus 2. Now it is in continuous conjugation. Like obeys Huckel's rule. What is Huckel's rule? 4N plus 2 pi electrons if you calculate. If after simplifying, where N equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, then definitely it is aromatic. So all should be satisfied, then only aromatic. Any one fail also, that is not aromatic. That is not aromatic. Calculate 4n plus 2. How many pi electrons? 3 pi bonds. 3 pi bonds means how many electrons, students? Yes, 6 electrons. 6 pi electrons, right? Can you simplify this one? 4n equal to how much answer? 6 minus 2, right? 6 minus 2. Then n equal to 1. That's it. N equal to 1. Satisfied. Yes, definitely this is aromatic. Simply on paper, which is having benzene ring, definitely aromatic compound. which is having benzene ring, definitely there are aromatic compounds. Okay, now this one, this is also cyclic structure, no? It is also conjugation. It is also conjugation. See, conjugation structure, what you will write here, double bond like this. It is in conjugation, cyclic, planar, continuous conjugation. But you will see the fourth rule, 4n plus 2 equal to, calculate, children, what is this? Two bonds means 4 pi electrons, right? So what about 4n? 4n equal to how much? 4 minus 2. Then n equal to 4n equal to 2. Then n equal to 2 by 4. 2 by 4 is nothing but 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is nothing but fractional value, 0.5. If you are getting 0.5, that's all. That is anti-aromatic. It's not aromatic. Non-aromatic. It is not aromatic. It is not aromatic. We have anti-aromatic compounds, non-aromatic compounds, aromatic compounds. Detailed explanation coming days I am going to do. Finally, I am saying it is not aromatic. Clear, students? That's all. Now, next one. Next one, very interesting one. Functional groups. Most of the students, they have idea in school level, some general formulas, some functional groups, names and all. Along with that, some additional points also I had given students. Please, everybody listen this one and everybody try to understand while explanation. After that, make a note all the points. See, first one, OH is the functional group, alcohols, general formula. GF is nothing but general formula, ROH. Oxygen, only single oxygen. Students, here another confusion is there. Most of the students, R they are asking. R equal to alkyl group. Alkyl group. What is alkyl group here? Methyl. Next, ethyl. Like this you can take it. Propyl, you can take like this. Next one more is there. Next one more. AR is nothing but aromatic. See, I have written here, no? AR, aromatic compounds, AR we are representing. That's it. But here I have written only alkyl groups. Alkyl groups. Suppose if you want to write methyl alcohol structure, how to write methyl alcohol? CH3OH. That's it. Methyl alcohol. Clear, students? Like that. Ethyl alcohol means C2H5. Propyl alcohol means C3H7. Like that we can substitute. Alcohols, what is the general molecular formula? OH. We can write ROH. Ethers, single oxygen ethers, ROR. Acids, carboxylic acids, RC double bond OH. This is COX. X is nothing but halogen. Acid halides. RC double bond O. In or else you can write expanded forms also. RC double bond OX. Sometimes they will ask you to calculate number of sigma bonds. That's why you have to write expanded form. Next one. Amides. C double bond ONH2. This is amide. C double bond ONH2. We call it as amides. Now next one. Esters. Esters is nothing but C. R, C double bond, O, O, R. This group. R, C double bond, O, O, R. This group we call it as esters. Anhydrides. It plays important role, students. Anhydrides. Little more clear I can write. R, C double bond, O. O, C double bond, O. This is yes, anhydride. C double bond OR is nothing but only esters. But here C double bond O, additional oxygen. Again the same group it is repeating. Here same group, middle oxygen. Only middle oxygen is nothing but ethers. But only this group one time means esters. Two times means, what is this? Anhydrides, right? Next, aldehydes. End group always hydrogen, that is hydrogen end group always, that is aldehydes. Next to CO, that is ketones, RC double bond OR, this group, ketones. Now next one, thioalcohols. Whenever we see sulfur compounds, thioalcohols, RSH, and thioethers. Oxygen means normal ethers, S means thioethers. Okay, RSR. Next, CN means cyanides, RC triple bond N. Wherever nitrogen is there, it forms triple bonds. Next, NC, isocyanates, RN triple bond C. CC single bond, alkenes. Already we have seen in above case, CNH2N plus 2. C double bond C, alkenes. C triple bond C, alkynes. And this is SO3H, sulfonic acid, RSO3H, RSO3H formula. Okay, RSO3H. Next, R and H2. Two hydrogens are there, then we call it as primary amine C. And only one hydrogen is there, then secondary amine. There is no hydrogens, we call it as tertiary amines. Okay, now see, look into this here. Next, NO2 group is nothing but nitro compounds, RNO2 generally we are writing. Next, F means fluorides. That to alkyl fluoride. Suppose if you have written here CH3F, if you have written here CH3F, then what we call as methyl fluoride. Cl means methyl chloride, methyl bromide, methyl iodate. Like this is what group I said, alkyl group. It's okay, alkyl fluoride. Same like that, RCl. Chlorides, bromides and iodides also you can write. Clear? Now next point. Next, last one, N double bond N compounds, we call it as azo compounds, N double bond N compounds, azo compounds. This is introduction part of organic chemistry. So, next video, I am going to start nomenclature. Before going to the nomenclature, everybody must learn these functional groups and introduction part. Why we are learning organic chemistry? What is the reason? Next one, why carbon only forms multiple bonds? What is catenation property? Main three reasons to show the many organic compounds. No, we are learning many organic compounds means reason is carbon. Why only carbon? Due to catenation property, due to tetravalency of carbon. And next one, carbon has ability to form multiple bonds, right? Up to there. Next one, classification also we have to learn. Their aromatic and other points also, saturated, unsaturated, all I had given, learn. After that, the main important thing is functional groups. 23 functional groups which we are using in first year and second year I had given to you. Everybody must note down these points and get ready for the next video. Thank you students. Thanks for watching. And please subscribe our channel, whoever not subscribed. And please share to others also. Thank you. Thanks for watching once again.